Hey y'all, it's Diane with Shaw Craft One and My Old Barn Door, also Digital Diane Designs for Digitals in Etsy and Barn Door Treasures on eBay. These are going to be a few pockets that are just quick and easy, and I'm going to show you a couple of things that you can do to make them super pretty in no time at all. So grab all of your goodies. Basically, to make these pockets, you just need some papers. You can do digitals. You can do, these are some of my digitals. You can do old book pages. You can make pockets out of pretty much any kind of paper that you want to make them out of. I love making them out of these. These are old book covers, like from old paperback books, and they have that gorgeous patina on them. So I like using these to make pockets with, and maybe we'll go ahead and just pull that one out to make a pocket with. But today we're going to get to as many pockets as we can, and then we'll do more in the next video. So we're going to go fast on these because the whole point of these videos is to give you quick references for different pockets for your journals. So the first pocket we're going to make out of this vintage book cover. It's a paperback book cover. And I am making pockets to go in like this size journal, and some are a little bit bigger, but mostly, you know, kind of this size. So I'm going to use this as a guide to measure because I'm not a measurer. So I'm just going to take my page that I want my pocket to be made out of. I'm going to take my ruler and I'm going to line it up. I don't know if you can see this. Hopefully you can. Let me see. There we go. Right here is the edge of that first page. So that just kind of gives me a guide of, you know, how far I want or how wide I want my paper to be. So I'm just going to tear it. Y'all know I'm not a cutter. I don't cut. So we're just going to tear. Okay, so now we have our strip of paper, which is wide enough for our journal. And basically, you're just going to turn it over and fold up. But actually, I think I want to fold it this way because I want this patina to show. You could cut this and do it, but this is the first type of pocket. I'm not going to, you know, make it complicated. I tend to do that sometimes. I just give you too much information and it makes things complicated. Okay, so simple pocket. You just fold up from the bottom. I didn't get that good and straight, but that's okay. And then you're just going to take glue, put it on two sides. Like so, and there you have a pocket. And then once you've got the pocket glued on both sides, then you can decorate it any way you want to. Here is an example of one that I have decorated. It's just a book page. You don't have to sew, but you can sew if you want to. But let me just take the ephemera out real quick so you can kind of see the actual pocket. So this is the pocket. I added some of my vintage ledgers as a background. This one, I probably wouldn't add that as a background, maybe just a small strip because I want that patina to show. And then I put a little piece of embossed vellum here and made another little pocket. So when you get it finished, you know, you can have all kinds of cute stuff. These pieces of ephemera are some, they're an actual digital that I just released, I think yesterday. I just released it, and I'll insert a flip through of the pages of this digital in the video here. Okay, so that is pocket number one. Pocket number two is going to be super simple. Basically, it's going to look something like this. So it's going to be a little pocket like this. So this is a digital, one of my digitals. I can show you this one too. So basically, all you're going to do is you're going to make sure that the your sheet of paper is the, you know, like it doesn't overwhelm the pocket, I mean the book page, you know, so whatever journal that you're putting it in, you don't want it to be too big for your journal page. So basically you're just going to fold it in half, and you can make either side be, you know, the side that you have facing you, but this one I'm going to make a little bit smaller. So I'm just going to tear it right there, and that way it's, you know, it's not so overwhelmingly large. And then I'm just going to put glue here and glue here and fold it over, and there you have a cute little pocket. Okay, and it can be open on this side, it can be open on this side, or you can even, if your book page is wide enough, you can open it, you know, going up that way. So very versatile. So with this little pocket, what I did was I turned it over and used a few of my scraps from some digitals that I was working with. This is a labels digital that I just put in the shop because it's kind of Valentine-y, you know, it's a little romantic type little label thing. So those are in the shop too. I'll put a link to it. And then I just made a little pocket out of some of my scraps, added the little label on there, and this is some of the ephemera from that digital that I showed you. And so I just made a little pocket there. So you have a pocket there and then a pocket on the inside, and I just added a little goodie for the pocket on the inside. So that is pocket number two. Pocket number three is super simple. It's just basically a book page. You just take a book page and you sew a piece of fabric across the front to make a little pocket. Or you can glue if you don't want to sew. So you might want to double up your book pages. I put two book pages together, and then I just simply glued around the three sides and made, you know, to make the little pocket. So, and then this one I did with the clear, like the see-through dotted Swiss type fabric. And so when you do this, you just take it and you glue around the back. So we'll do one of those super quick. So I'm just going to take, this is just a book page that's kind of laying around. I'm going to go ahead and fold this up here. And then I'm just going to get rid of that. And this is kind of a thinner book page, so I want it to be a little thicker, so I'm just going to fold it in half. Actually, I'm going to take some of this off. So I just took like the little white edges off the top and the bottom. And then basically, I'm just going to fold this in half, so it's going to give it a little more stability. And then I'm just going to glue these two pieces together like that. And now it's a little bit thicker, so it's more sturdy. And then I have this little bowl of some little snippets of, I think these are off of Sari's. And so I thought this one would be pretty to do as a pocket here. So basically, we're going to put glue across the bottom here. So I just put a little bead of Fabri-Tac. Now, in order to keep it from showing through my fabric, I'm just going to kind of rub that Fabri-Tac in a little bit so that it's, you know, hopefully won't show through the fabric. Now I'm going to leave a little bit of my fabric on each side, and I'm just going to lay my my fabric down onto the page, onto the glue. Okay, then I'm going to turn it over. I'm going to put Fabri-Tac here and here and rub them both in, and then just fold the fabric into the glue around onto the back side. You want to give it a minute to dry, and you want to do it on both sides. We're going to fold this one over like so, and I'm just kind of pulling it kind of tight so that it doesn't have any, you know, it's not gappy in the front. And then there you have a book page pocket. You can decorate the top if you want to, add in some ephemera pieces. Let's do this one. It's a little bit bigger, so you can add in some ephemera pieces. We got a little stamp sheet here. Nope, that clashes with that green. I do have some ice coupon things in here. Let's use one of these. I like the color of that with the green. And then, oh, here's some ice coupons. Let's do this color ice coupons. And there you have a super cute little pocket. So that is pocket number two. No, that's pocket number three. I couldn't remember. Okay, so there we have it. We have pocket number three. So super cute, super quick, super easy. So you have pocket number one, which is just a simple fold-up pocket. It turns out super cute. You have pocket number two, which is just a piece of paper that you fold in half, glue on two sides, and then you have a super cute little pocket that you can tuck things in. So that's pocket number two. And then pocket number three is the one we just did. So you can make all kinds of different, you can make this one all kinds of different ways. You can sew it, you can glue it, you can do it however you want to. But I'm just trying to get you a couple of different examples for you to see. So that is three pockets in no time at all. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you go and find the next one that's coming. I'm gonna have several of these, so go look for all of the pocket videos, and let me know if you have any comments or questions. Leave them in the box below, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching. Big hugs.